at 5:30. What could knitting and watching the weather possibly have in common, right? Well, Mike Randall meets a Cowlesville woman who has the answer to the question.
She's nuts about knitting.
So I use a lot of these still to make sweaters.
And fanatical about the fiber arts.
This is one of the prettiest projects I've got going right now.
Amanda Hartridge taught herself to knit about 20 years ago. These days, she even spins.
I spin wool into yarn, and I set up my spinning wheel and spin.
This is like Little House on the Prairie here.
Pretty much, and we homeschool, so.
Her latest project has had her knitting up a storm for the past year.
And then you can see we had a really deep cold snap.
Okay, maybe not a storm, but a couple of cold snaps and definitely a big heat wave.
You can see what happened this summer. It's basically red.
She's working on what you could call a weather Afghan.
Each row is the high temperature of the day.
She started it all the way back on January 1st.
January here, it started out pretty cold. The dark purple is our coldest color until we get up through probably February is about here.
She keeps track of the high temperature each day in a journal in case she gets behind.
This row I'm knitting is October 16th, so I'm pretty much caught up.
Amanda calls it a temperature blanket. Her friend Monica is working on one too.
Yeah, my colors are a little different than Amanda's.
And of course, that's the tricky part of this project, picking out your colors.
And then these are about every 10 degrees, so the 50s, the 60s, the 70s.
And the other tricky part is keeping an eye on Western New York weather.
I mean, what better way to keep track of how crazy Buffalo's weather is than a blanket on your couch, right?
Amanda got more red days this summer than she bargained for.
It's pretty solid red, and the red is the 80s.
Her daughter Morgan is already a knitter, and daughter Catherine appreciates mom's handiwork.
This is a bunny that mommy made.
And in true knitter fashion, Amanda's already planning next year's blanket.
I was even toying with the idea of doing all neutrals next year.
And no doubt our Western New York weather will not disappoint by continuing to be quite colorful. In Colesville, Mike Randall, 7 Eyewitness News.